Hello and welcome to the Tadabase overview video. In this video, we'll be discussing some of the features in the builder and we'll build out a simple job management application. So let's dive right in.
When you first come onto the builder, you'll be prompted to create your first app. You can choose to create an app using one of our many templates or by creating an app from scratch. Starting with a template is quick and convenient. We have a large and quickly growing collection of template apps categorized by industry. Simply choose the template you're looking for and select the Use Template to add the template to your app dashboard. Then customize away, personalizing any or all parts of the app with your unique data and app needs. Alternatively, you can build your app from scratch. By starting from scratch, you can manually build your unique data structure, upload your existing spreadsheets, and create the pages and layouts exactly the way you envision them. For this video, we'll explore building an app from scratch. Once inside the builder, you'll see several tabs on the left side of the page. Let's explore each tab to understand its purpose. We'll start with the Data Builder tab. Since database applications are all about data, we recommend starting here, where you'll build and define the data structure for your app. Inside the Data Builder, there are tables, which is the core of your data. Since many of you are already familiar with spreadsheets, we'll use that as our analogy to help understand what data tables are. Generally, when you organize your data in Excel, you'd create a new sheet for each type of data. For example, you might have separate sheets for customers, orders, and jobs. We would do the same with data tables, and we'd name them accordingly. In spreadsheets, you'd add a new column for each type of data, like name, email, and phone number. In the Data Builder, this would be a field. You need to define the type of field you plan on using based on the type of data you plan to store. You can easily do this by choosing one of the field categories. Let's move over to the Records tab. Now you have a table with fields. Adding a new record is like populating a row in a spreadsheet. Next, we'll quickly add any other types of data tables and their appropriate fields. Here we have a jobs table as well as a job notes table. For our use case, we want to keep a log of notes for each job. We therefore need to make a connection from the job notes table to the jobs table. This will allow us to connect each note to a particular job. We are now done with building our data structure. The next step would be to build the application that can utilize this data. But before we move on, let's explore some of the options in the Data Builder. The Fields tab is where you can add and customize fields as we just demonstrated. The Records tab allows you to view, add, and edit records that belong to this data table. You can also add and edit fields from this page as well. The Settings tab has some advanced and default settings that can be unique to each data table. In the Imports tab, you'll have the ability to create a template that will be used for importing records on a recurring basis. For example, if you want to give your users the ability to import records from your app, you can create a template that will ensure the data is imported and columns are matched correctly. Exports are similar to imports, where you can predefine specific records to be exported with the click of a button. Finally, the Tasks tab enables you to create automated tasks that can be run on specific schedules. For example, send a custom email to each customer on Monday with a reminder of their scheduled jobs. Okay, now let's move on to the next step. Let's get an overview of the Page Builder. In the Page Builder, we have layouts which contain pages and pages which contain components. Layouts are templates that contain multiple pages. For example, if you want the same menu on the top of every page, you would put a menu component inside the layout, and it would appear on every page contained in the layout. Pages are where you actually add your data in what we call components. Components are used to interact with the data from the Data Builder. For example, a form component enables you to add or edit records, whereas a table component allows you to view those records. Each of the components are highly customizable. We recommend you play around and check out the extensive options. Let's create a new page so we can add and view a table of our jobs. We'll assign it to the default layout and choose to add this page to the existing menu on the page. Pages are divided into rows and columns using the Bootstrap grid system. From a bird's eye view, it works as follows. Each page can have unlimited rows and each row can be divided into any combination of columns equaling less than 12. For example, if you want to divide your page in half, you'd add two size 6 columns. Or if you want to divide the page into three equal columns, you'd add three of the size 4 columns. Once you have the structure the way you like, you can add any component inside that column. We'll add a table component to view jobs on the left, and on the right, we'll add a form component to add new jobs. Let's add the jobs table first and select Quick Add, which uses some predefined settings to assist in creating your app quicker. Here you'll see some additional options, which we'll go over in a later tutorial. Next, we'll add the jobs form on the right. Now we can preview this page in our app. Let's use our form to populate this table with some sample data. If you recall, earlier we added a job notes data table so we can keep a log of notes relating to each job. The recommended approach would be to create a child page where we can see additional details about each job and view job notes connected with that job. In the page builder, click on the jobs table component. Under the links, you'll see a record details page. By adding this link, we will automatically create the child page to this table. Now we'll navigate to the record details page we've just added and add a form component to add new job notes. Next, we'll add a table to view all the job notes that are related to this job. Now, when we preview this app, we have a new link to view more details about each job. From within the details page, we can add notes that are related to this job. Thanks for watching and happy building!